Meta just stepped into the game of 3D AI, dropping free open source AI model called SAM3D. How good it is against another open source models, how difficult it is to install locally, requirements and limitations, all in this video. Hey guys, I'm Steph, 3D engineer, and I already tested SAM3D in all possible ways. And I have a lot to share. So first of all, what is SAM3D? SAM3D is a part of Segment Anything model of Meta, which in the first place is about segmenting images and stuff and extracting some information from there. And continuation of it is like SAM3D models, which include SAM3D objects and SAM3D body. They have different outputs, but based on the same idea. So basically, if SAM is about segmenting, then SAM3D is about reconstructing that objects in 3D. For us, it's important to know that it's open source, and basically if you go to Meta page, you can go to download, you immediately end up on the Git, you can clone this repo, install all dependencies, download the actual models from Hugging Face, and run it locally, which is amazing. The more open source models we have, the better. Now let's actually generate some models. The good news, you can go to Playground right from here. Here you can give a try to all SAM features, which includes the segmentation of images and video, and of course 3D objects and 3D bodies. So we're gonna press this one. I'm gonna use one of my images I used for benchmarks. So here is our character. Here we can see it starts with segmentation. So basically we add a mask to define the character. Basically pressing, we choose add or remove, and I need to add all the parts of the character, make sure it is masked correctly. Again, because this is a part of segmentation model, and we can press generate model. One of the coolest thing here is the speed, and this model is really, really fast. Like it basically creates models in around 10 seconds, which is 10-20 times faster than other models. So here is our result. Now, before we continue with 3D models, a few words about 3D bodies. It's not really about creating 3D models, it's about extracting poses from images that can be used further. This is an amazing tool. So if you work with NVIDIA production, animations and stuff, it might be very useful to you to look into. Getting back to our 3D model. So here, right now, when you create a model, you press add effects. Here you can add some additional effects and shader stuff. This is not really useful thing for us. It's only for preview. But if we press one of the 3D effects, we can see that our model basically disintegrated. And the way it disintegrated, it tells me that this model is not a real model. And this is one thing that you need to know. SAM3D inside built of two things: Gaussian splatting and reconstructed mesh from Gaussian splatting. On Meta's playground, what you see, it is actually a splat. And if we go and press share button, it will say exporting video. So it basically creates a video, but we need to go to 3D model tab. And here there is a download 3D model. But if we press that, we'll see that sam3d.ply is downloaded, which is basically a splat file. So unfortunately, for most of the cases, using Playground for downloading models for free is not for you. But it doesn't mean that Meta models are only export in splats. The model itself actually allow to export meshes with baked texture. So if we take a look on their paper, we can see that there is mesh decoder and Gaussian splat decoder. However, for texture, Gaussian splat is baked into the mesh. And this is important knowledge because it will explain the way the texture looks. Look at this. Here is the model on the website. If we zoom a little bit closer, we can start seeing that it is made of splats, right? It's some half transparent sometimes. It's a little bit blurry and stuff. This is basically baked into the texture. Here I run this locally with texture baking. Here's how it looks. So you can see this blurriness is basically transferred to the model. And again, this is explained by the pipeline, right? So here the same model, but it's already a mesh, also generated with SAM3D, but on my inference. However, if we take a look on some benchmark made by Meta, they say that 3D shape and scene reconstruction performing really well compared to the model list here. So we can see 3D shape and texture preference test, win rate, and we can see against Trellis, Hunyuan 3D, Direct 3D S2, Tripa SG, and High 3D Gen. It performs really well. But it's important to know, all listed models are open source models. They are not comparing themselves with paid models, which obviously performs better. Let's confirm if that's true or not. I did some generations of textured mesh of both SAM3D and Hunyuan 2.1. Here is meta model actually looked really good. And here is the same model generated with Hunyuan 2.1. I definitely go for SAM3D. Another example. Here's our Pokemon. Okay, blurry texture, but the shape is more or less nice. Here we go to Hunyuan 2.1. We can definitely tell it's sharper, but less accurate in some places. Messy parts here, here, and here. But let's say I go for Hunyuan anyway, just because it's sharper and have more details. Another example. So here is SAM3D, and here the same guy. I don't know why it generated such a long sword. The face is ugly there and there, but maybe there are more details on the texture. So maybe I still go for Hunyuan 2.1. One more example, a chair. This one actually I like a lot. Looks quite clean, not much artifacts. The same one from Hunyuan 2.1. I think it's also not that bad, but it looks less logical. It's more problems with textures. Coloring is so-so. So I'll go for meta this time. This looks like an asset I can actually drop somewhere maybe. And the last one, teapot. So we can see the wire here look like this. Okay, more or less accurate texture. Not perfect at all, but can do. And the same thing with Hunyuan 2.1. For some reason, it generated a plane. Some mess around the wires and problem with the texture. So definitely go for meta here. So depending on the benchmark, I think this is actually true. In my opinion, the difference is not that significant, but if we talk about some world objects and shape accuracy, it is really better. We can also compare it with paid 3D models. That's super easy to do. You can always go to top3d.ai and check how it performs. It is definitely higher than Hunyuan 2.1 and actually higher than some paid model like previous generation of Tripo, which is actually quite good results for open source model. Here you can also go to compare mode, select SAM3D here, and select any model that you want to compare it to, and make a decision if it's worth it or not. Now, how about running it locally? So basically, you go back to Git repo, you clone it. You'll need to go to installation guide. Here it is. And here's the important thing you need to know before trying to install. The full pipeline, only possible on Linux. I actually managed to run it on Windows, but only mesh generation pipeline. Dependencies and libraries responsible for texturing part will not be installed within Windows environment, so you'll need to go for Linux environment. And while we're talking about running models locally, I want to take chance and recommend my good friend Philip from Pixel Artistry. He also talks about 3D AI and does amazing tutorials about how to run locally models such as Tripo, Hunyuan, Direct3D S2. He does amazing job preparing all the files, to definitely not get lost watching his tutorials. So definitely take a look, and we are continuing. About the VRAM, 32 gigs required for pipeline with texturing. However, on my 12 gigs, I managed to successfully run mesh generation. However, it was not that fast as on Meta website. It took around 2-3 minutes per each mesh. Other than that, when I installed it within Linux environment, it was pretty fine. It took me around 3 hours to figure out, but it all works really well and super fast. On GPU with 40 gigabyte or more, it really creates model within 10 to 15 seconds, which is amazing. And don't forget that to download the models, you first need to register on Hugging Face and apply for the models. However, it looks like they do not reject anyone, and you will definitely have an access within a day. But if you guys really need step-by-step guide how to install it locally, let me know in the comment, and if there will be enough likes, I will consider making a separate video about it. So basically that's it. What do we have eventually? New player on open source 3D AI, which is amazing. It performs better than other open sources. It definitely has its pros and cons, but for some cases like prop generation, extracting assets from images, that can be an amazing tool. Drop in the comments what you think. I really want to hear about use cases you might come up with. That's it for today. Like and subscribe, because this month there will be content you can't miss.